KSBW Weather Plus with Jim VanderZwan.
All right, another beautiful day, and we lucked out, got a little bit of sun going in places that typically don't see a lot of it in the summertime, but the fog season really ramps up in July and August. But for June, hey, we got a little mixing here. Started off with the stuff in the Salinas Valley. North winds cleared it all the way south of Nepenthe there, so we ended up with a nice day. 81 in Boulder Creek. We had a 78 going there in Ben Lomond, Scotts Valley. 68 in Santa Cruz, degree cooler in Watsonville with most lows in the 50s, so that was pretty much what we expected. And low to mid-60s around most of the Monterey Peninsula. Pick a spot there. Overnight lows in the 50s, 79 in Carmel Valley. And then we ended up with some pretty nice numbers elsewhere around the state. Getting hot in the deserts, triple digits, 60s and 50s. Oh, yeah, we got something jumping out of form here. Okay, well, we're back to Salinas. We got 71 here, and I'm not sure what's going on here. This is not where we need to be. Okay, here we go. 90 degrees in Morgan Hill. Maps somehow got out of sequence. All right, now we get caught up. 91 in Sacramento right now, 75 in Lake Tahoe, beautiful up in the mountains. Now the rest of the country doing the hot. 108 in Phoenix right now, while it's 65 in Seattle, it's 84 in Denver, it's 83 in New York, but it was much warmer than that. 90 at one point, and lots of 80s and muggy. And at one point, 111 degrees in Phoenix already, and we haven't even hit the 4th of July. It could be a long, hot summer. Meanwhile, scattered thunderstorms out over the Intermountain West of the Rocky Mountain states. Cold front just down to the Carolinas. Some good rain there left behind. Lots of flooding in parts of Iowa and Illinois. And a lot of thunderstorms starting to work up in the Lone Star State through most of the Gulf. You'll see that little spot there in the middle? That is the eye of a hurricane. It's going to cause some problems over the next couple of days, pushing a lot of that warm, muggy air and a lot of thunder and lightning and rain in the southern part of Texas all the way to the Gulf Coast. The storm itself is the first one of the season, the first tropical storm in the Atlantic anyway. Alex is the name. Started back in Friday. It's now just barely getting ready to make its way into a hurricane status. Winds about 70 miles an hour. Give it another 4 and it's a hurricane. Should make it here a little bit later on tonight. But then it's going to move inland south of Brownsville, Texas. Should bring some wind and some rain and probably a storm surge, but indirectly it's sending a lot of moisture. It's a very broad storm, so it's causing some problems out in the Gulf with the folks who are trying to deal with that oil spill, but not directly affecting it. Meanwhile, an upper level low shows up nicely in the water vapor satellite, but that's the Queen Charlotte Islands. That's Vancouver Island. You're way down here, so there's not much left of this, just a little water vapor in the high levels of the sky. Hardly even enough to make for any high clouds out of it. Low clouds, not even all that much on the microcast model, but I'm thinking it'll still reform once this north wind dies off tonight, sneak into the Salinas Valley, maybe out to San Juan Bautista, then back off a little bit. The marine layer will be a little bit higher by a couple of hundred feet, but that's about it. So we'll still look for that morning mist. 60s, yeah, we can figure that for the peninsula. For 70s for the South Bay, we'll try for some low to mid 80s around Morgan Hill and Gilroy. San Jose and Hollister, though, will figure mid to upper 70s, benefiting from a little afternoon sea breeze. 68 in Salinas, then a lot of 70s and a few 80s. Greenfield, King City, probably have to get all the way down to Camp Roberts to get those 90s going. And a lot of sun after the morning, low clouds. And we'll figure low to mid 60s. Around the peninsula again tomorrow, 71 in Carmel Valley, with most lows staying on the mild side, typical for summer, really. 60s north of Moss Landing out to Davenport, and 70s for the Santa Cruz Mountains. In other words, if you like today, you're going to love tomorrow. It's a good place to get stuck for a while, too. Fair, basically. And then low clouds of fog getting established along the coast, locally inland in the valley. That'll start the day with just a little bit of gray and a little mist. But by afternoon, I think we'll have sun for most anyway. And that morning fog and drizzle also burning off for mostly sunny, so we can hope for the best there and get a little bit of clearing. Now, by the weekend, it looks like marine layer does drop, so it will warm up a little bit back to normal. A lot of 80s and some 90s for the valleys over the 4th of July weekend, and mostly 60s and on into the mid to upper 70s with a little more sun and a little less sea fog after a couple of misty days. So this may well turn out to be a rather pleasant 4th of July. I don't think we'll get rid of the fog completely, but enough that it's going to give people, a little choice where they want to spend their birthday, nation's birthday.
Yeah.
How's that?
There you go.
Yeah?
Always depends where you are.
That's right.
Good. Wherever the barbecue is.
That's right. Wherever you can find a good fire going.
Very good. All right.